Australian universities are like dinosaurs and can't survive through the next decade unless they reinvent their business models. A report by leading accounting firm Ernst & Young has found there needs to be a complete rethink on staffing, funding and competition for students. Peter Rowan is education leader at Ernst & Young and he's in our Melbourne studios for us this morning. Peter, it seems to be very much a case of adapt or perish for some of our best known education institutions. Why have things become so tough?
I think there's been a change in a number of factors influencing the sector. Drop in demand partly from the international students, the impact of the new digital technologies and matters of that nature. However, I probably don't share your view that it's all doom and gloom. Our observation would be from the research that most vice-chancellors, indeed all we spoke to, are very aware of these changes and are indeed preparing for their universities to adapt to that change. And I think the Australian universities have an outstanding track record in the past in adapting to the export markets, and our view is so long as they act quickly, they have a great future.
Well, most industries have had to adapt to this new world reality in recent years. Why is education behind the eight ball?
Again, I'm sure they're that behind the eight ball. I think it's been a certain rush of changes impacting them, and in a sense, not quite what I call the perfect storm, but in terms of international markets becoming highly contestable, you have the UK, you have Canada, you have other countries moving into these areas very aggressively. You have the impact of the international universities such as Stanford and the Massachusetts Institute of Technology starting to introduce their online courses. These are fast changes impacting a sector which has been largely protected domestically. However, again, it's just these factors have all come together at once, and it's really beholden on the universities here in Australia to respond quite quickly and strategically to these changes.
Well, universities have also had to put up with this new demand-driven funding model from this year. How are they coping with that? What impact are you seeing?
Generally, they've obviously had to... The first impact, I think, is much more tuned in to the needs of students in a way not seen before. Much more emphasis on their own brand, making students aware of what the university offers in terms of courses, content, experience, and we would see over time a greater focus on tailoring experiences to individual student cohorts, differentiating the needs of mature age students, people with kids at home or, you know, they're studying at night, compared to the needs of school leavers. And I think that would be a very positive thing on the sector, but the universities need to make those changes, and those changes are emerging.
Well, with what you're saying there, we've also seen a very strong move towards industry-specific education, which of course is available online and in the workplace. Is that draining students away from universities as well?
To me, it's simply an alternative, if indeed they're going purely into the industry-based training. However, what we would see over time is industry and universities coming together much more and integrating the learning experience. It's a little bit like the old apprenticeship schemes from many years ago, where you actually combine on-the-job training with the formal education. And rather than seeing it as an alternative, our view would be we think universities should be seeking greater industry integration into the learning experience for their individual students, and the industry equally should be benefiting from the research and the learnings within universities to provide better education for their workers.
Well, one of the benefits of that sort of education is the fact that it can be fast-tracked. Most university degrees are still those laborious old four-year things. Are we likely to see an end to that and a way of fast-tracking courses?
I would share your view on that. If you think of the academic year, it's still largely a half a year of teaching and a half a year not teaching. It's based on an old model. Our view will be more and more students will be looking to fast track their learning. They can't afford to be staying in part-time work, working in kitchens and cafes for 4 or 5 years to fund their studies. They'll be looking for a more concentrated effort. And we see this particularly mature age students, but I think school leavers as well. And I would agree with you. I think one of the challenges for universities is to have a more concentrated and intense period of teaching while retaining the quality standards in order to get students through the system more quickly and out into the workplace.
All right, well, I guess it's a case of watch this space from the next couple of years. All right, Peter, thank you very much. Peter Rowan there from Ernst & Young in Melbourne.